In this illustration, we'll analyze sphere rolling on a wedge. We are given that a uniform solid sphere of mass m and radius r, rolling without slipping down on an inclined wedge, of same mass as shown. Here we are required to find the velocity of wedge, when sphere reaches the bottom of this wedge. Now, in this situation we can analyze the case when the sphere reaches the bottom of wedge. Then wedge will attain a leftward velocity because in this situation no external force is acting on the system in horizontal direction. So its system center of mass must be addressed. Here the wedge is of mass m, and the sphere is also of mass m. Here we can consider if this sphere attains a velocity v1 with respect to b wedge, and wedge is moving toward left with a velocity v2 with respect to ground. Then here we can write as no external force in horizontal direction is acting on system. Here we use the conservation of momentum in horizontal direction. We use by conservation of momentum. As here we can write toward left the wedge is attained a momentum mv2 and toward right the ball is attained a momentum m. This v1 cos theta minus v2. Because here we have taken the v1 as velocity of ball with respect to wedge. So in this situation, with respect to horizontal v1 is moving at an angle theta, so ball is moving toward right at v1 cos theta as well as it is moving with the wedge toward left with v2. So simplifying this relation here m gets cancelled out. And this will give us v1 is equal to 2v2 by cos theta. And we can write by work energy theorem the kinetic energy gain in wedge as well as in that of ball is due to the work done by gravity. So here work done by gravity is mgh. And that should be the gain in kinetic energy of wedge plus ball. So for wedge it is half m v2 square. Plus for ball we can write it is half m. It has two velocity components, so we can write one as the horizontal velocity component, which is v1 cos theta minus v2 whole square plus v1 sine theta whole square plus the rotational energy attained by the ball as it is rotating at angular speed omega, which is with respect to wedge its velocity is v1 divided by its radius. So we can write its rotational energy is half I omega square, which is 2 by 5 mr square multiplied by v1 by r whole square. Now, if we simplify this relation, here this gives us m gets cancelled out in the whole equation. This gives us 2gh is equal to v2 square plus v1 square plus v2 square minus 2v1 v2 cos theta plus 2 by 5 v1 square. And now for v1 we can substitute the value in terms of v2 from this equation. This gives us 2gh is equal to here this will be 2v2 square plus v1 square plus 2 by 5 v1 square. We can write as 7 by 5 v1 square. So this is 7 by 5. And v1 square we can write as 4v2 square divided by cos square theta. And minus here, we can write V1 cos theta is equal to 2V2, so this becomes 4V2 square. Further on simplifying this relation, we get the value of V2 is equal to under the root of 5GH divided by 14 sec square theta minus 5. That is a result of this problem.